What's up, guys? Charles here. If this rumor is true, the RTX 5080 might feature similar bandwidth to the current flagship in the Ada series, the RTX 4090. According to WCCF tech sources, the 5080 might debut with 32 gigabits per second chips instead of the previously rumored 28 gigabits per second. These are the fastest GDDR7 modules currently being sampled by graphics card manufacturers, and it seems that the RTX 5080 might feature such memory. An important detail is that the card is allegedly using the GB203-400 GPU, which is limited to a 256-bit memory bus, half the width of the flagship RTX 5090 model. However, since it would have 4 GBPs faster memory, the actual bandwidth of 1,024 gigabytes per second would slightly surpass that of the 384-bit 4090, which is 1,008 gigabits per second. Previous leaks suggested that the card might have 10,752 CUDA cores, more than 5,600 fewer cores than the RTX 4090. Yet the card is said to be 10% faster, as claimed by co-Pete Sevenkimi, though it wasn't specified if that referred to raster or ray trace performance. If all these rumors prove true, the RTX 5080 would be faster and require less power than the RTX 4090, despite having fewer cores, less memory capacity, and a narrower memory bus. There's also a new update on RTX 5070, the third Blackwell RTX 50 model. It is now said to be arriving alongside 5090 and 5080 at CES 2025. But as usual, it would launch later. Furthermore, the exact specs remain unknown, but the media is now claiming that it will feature GB205 GPU, not GB203 as the 5080 model. In other words, we have a similar situation to the Ada series, where there will be a visible gap between XX70 and XX80 class tiers. The GB203 GPU is to feature up to 84 streaming multiprocessors, 10,752 CUDA cores, which will be used by the upcoming RTX 5080, it is claimed. That said, the potential 5080 Super would have to use GB202 GPU instead to have more cores. Meanwhile, the GB205 GPU is to feature up to 50 SMs or 6,400 cores, so the rumored 5070 card might either have this configuration or launch with fewer cores, akin to 4070 series. We also have an update from Kopit Sevenkimi, who claims that RTX 5070 will be a 250-watt card, a 50-watt increase over 4070. This suggests that there would be a 150-watt gap between 5080 and 5070. It is also confirmed that the card is 12 gigabytes, same capacity as 4070. Currently, NVIDIA is expected to unveil the new RTX 50 series at CES. The company has already confirmed the keynote will be hosted by Jensen Huang himself. That's it for today's video. Do consider subscribing for all the latest content on gaming, and as always, I'll see you at the next one. Peace out.